You know, really want to start off as, you know, mentioning, you know, just growing up, you know, school was always the biggest challenge for me, quite one of the biggest challenges, and something I was just ashamed about, or something I didn't have pride about, something I was embarrassed about, that's the word, something I never really thought, okay, I'm going to go to school and this is my thing. It was just, actually, it was just the opposite. I would go to school and it was learning and picking up, you know, keeping up with everyone. It was probably the biggest challenge I faced. And that's why I never really took any pride in it, and I would just go to school, and I just looked forward to recess. You know, long story short, you know, around 10th grade, I was, you know, really, my goal in life was to play in the NFL. People would ask me, Barry, what do you want to do when you grow up? I'm like, I'm going to play in the NFL, I'm going to win the Super Bowl, I'm going to be just like all those, I'm going to be a famous running back, that's what I want to do. And, you know, as I got to high school, I realized to play in the NFL, you had to go to college, right? And then you get drafted. That's the route. Then I told myself, okay, guess what? I have to go to college, and I need to really figure out my whole academic. Well, if I go to college, I have to get into college. Okay, a bell rang right there. And the first thing I realized, okay, you know what? I got to start caring about school. At the time, I wasn't doing well at school at all. Again, I was just going there, looking forward to sports, and just having fun. And then I told myself, you know, I discovered, because of my dyslexia, one thing I always avoided was reading. I told myself, you know, when it comes to a time to read or anything like that, I'm going to quickly, you know, not read, or, you know, not do my homework or whatever. And in fact, my reading level was very low, very, very low. And when I realized that, I said, you know what, I got to, you know, get my reading level back up. Then I took the SOLs. Now, the SOL stands for the Standard of Learning. Now, in the state of Virginia, is by law, you have to pass your SOLs to graduate. And the funny thing is, it happens to be my year was the first year they implemented that rule. So I'm like, oh gosh, can I be 1 year ahead? You know, just bump me up, you know. But in reality, that was actually at the perfect time. And then I told myself, you know, I'm really going to learn how to read at a much better level. I gotta get back to reading. And that's when I started staying after school. I start really, you know, learning how to do that. By learning how to read much better, helped me understand information. So when I read information, I could understand. Because my biggest weakness was those passages where you read and then you have to answer the questions. I would always forget. So by my senior year, it was my goal. My main goal was to pass these SOLs. By my senior year, it was, I remember most people take 2 hours or an hour and a half or not even like 45 minutes to take one exam. For one exam, it literally took me from before school until after school just on one exam. And I had a teacher read it to me, because I told the teacher, I said, you know what? I need someone to read it to me, because when I hear it, I can understand 10 times better. So, okay, fine. So, you know, we really gave me a great support, and, you know, and miraculously, I end up passing my SOLs, got my grades up, and at the time, everyone was telling me, you know, I don't think, you know, college is an option. Well, what about trade school? How about you learn how to go do, you know, carpentry, or go do this, or do something? That never was appealing to me. I always knew there was a greater vision that I was capable of doing. And so I graduated high school. Again, that was a huge miracle. And I applied to college. Okay, you know what? I made a football highlight tape. I sent it out to a whole bunch of colleges. And every single college, over 20 colleges I applied to, every single college rejected me. I was just like, okay, wow, what am I going to do? Like, Nova doesn't have a football team, you know? I can't do anything, you know? So I got to work out something. And, you know, and then, you know, I wrote a letter to the head, the admission office, George Mason, because I just got a letter in the mail saying, sorry, we're not going to accept you. I immediately, while I was crying, I was writing this letter. And I said, come on, this is why. I told him about how I failed at the SOL, how I could barely read at one point, and how my reading levels went up. I passed all my SOLs. I graduated high school, which was a huge miracle. And I explained that in the letter. He read the letter. I mailed it to him. The next couple of days, what happened? He gave me a phone call. He said, you know what? I read your letter. Unbelievable. I really was touched by it. Congratulations. You're going to Mason. Yeah. And at that moment, I figured out something. You can't take no for an answer. When life throws something at you, you can't just say, oh, I'm already late, I already missed it, you know, there's no point of going. Or you know what, it's too late to go back to school. Or you know what, it's too late to, you know, to start my own business. You know, it's too late to quit my job and to do what I'm really, really passionate about. You can't let that voice take over, because it will. So I got to college, and as soon as I got to college, you know, I was like, okay, wow, I'm actually in college. You know, and I went to college, and I started, you know, I said, you know, I'm going to be the best student. I'm going to, the very first day, I went to every single teacher, hey, my name is Barry, I can't wait to take your class, I'm going to get an A. I'm going to get an A, so be prepared to give me an A. You know, from the day one, I told them this. And I went to their office hours. I went every day. I would go talk to them. I would make up questions just so they know I'm asking questions. And after a while, the teachers really sensed how much I really wanted it, and they were willing to work with me so much. So, you know, I graduated college, and, you know, while I was playing college, I wanted to, again, the goal was to play in the NFL. I had a great, successful, you know, football career, which was the biggest learning experience of my life while I was playing college football. The adversity, the competition, the being competitive, self-competitive, while my teammates are working, while everyone else was working, I had to work times 10 just to keep up with them, and to out-compete them as well. And then I realized towards the end of my college career that, what, you know, NFL wasn't going to be an option, and that I wasn't going to go down that route. Then I realized, okay, you know what? Now what? What am I going to do right now? Football was it, and I was kind of upset, disappointed. I was kind of lost at a period of time when I realized that. And then I accepted it. Then I said, you know what? Everything happens for a reason. What football taught me was a lot of, you know, key fundamental principles that I can implement in my daily life. And with the dyslexia, you know, I remember, you know, even I had trouble memorizing the football plays. I would run, the play would be a toss to the right, and I'll see a hike, I'll run to the left, and it's a fumble, and everyone's yelling at me, Barry, the play's going this way. I'm like, oh man, my bad, coach, I'll get back in here. You know, I used to write the plays on my hand, you know, but again, that was another opportunity where I had to make a personal adjustment to make sure I'm not falling behind in my playing football. So.